The adorable baby gorilla who captured our hearts 18 years ago has come of age. Little Yakini was saved from the brink of death, bottle-fed and taught how to act as a gorilla. Now, as he celebrates this very special milestone, Yakini is reunited with the woman who raised him. Natalie Hunter has this special story.
The gorilla who stole the hearts of a nation. Born at Melbourne Zoo without a heartbeat, doctors from the Royal Children's and Royal Women's Hospital fought like crazy to keep him alive.
It was quite intense. He was born by cesarean and it caused some respiratory distress in Yakini. So we had to monitor him very closely.
But against all odds, little baby Yakini survived. But second time mum Yushka wasn't able to mother him on her own.
Yushka hasn't been able to observe other gorillas in a natural group raise their young ones, so she didn't quite know what to do with Missouri at the time, nor with Yakini. And of course, on top of that, the cesarean birth didn't help.
So Uli became Yakini's surrogate mum, along with support from the primate department team. She was there to bottle feed him around the clock. She was there for his first steps, his first birthday, and everything in between. It compared to a human baby?
It's not dissimilar to a human baby. You on at the job 24/7. You feed them every 3 to 4 hours, clean them, and it's pretty full on.
They're really dependent on you.
They're very dependent on their keepers, as they would be on their mothers if it would have been a natural birth. Yeah.
One of the really memorable moments was when you first introduced Yakini to Yushka, to his mum. What was that like?
Yushka is always, when she sees gorilla babies come in, whether they are hers or other ones, her main interest is what sex is it. So that's the first part she investigates. And she did the same with Yakini, yeah.
And then she reached out and gave
She reached out and touched and smelt and, yeah.
When he was old enough, Yakini was moved away from the home he'd always known with Uli at Melbourne Zoo to another zoo in Victoria, Werribee Open Range Zoo.
I did have a very special bond with him for all these years he was at Melbourne Zoo and growing up, yeah. I mean, you spent so much time with him initially. And it's great to see them integrated in the groups and behave normally, and you see them grow up.
Today, that little baby gorilla turns 18. Not only did he survive, but he's thriving as a silverback gorilla. And who better to wish him happy birthday than his human mum? You're about to see him for the very first time in a very long time. How are you feeling?
Oh.
So I'm very excited to see how much he has grown and whether he will recognize me or my voice maybe. So I'm really excited going down and having a look at Yakini. Hey boy, look at you. You good boy? Yes, I've seen you and you've seen me. You good boy. Hey, do me. Remember them fun days we had? Massive, isn't he? Can you look up to me?
Now he's grown a lot, hasn't he?
He's massive.
And so it continues, a relationship 18 years in the making.
They got their own body language.
Uli has some amazing stories to tell. She's worked as a primate keeper for more than 45 years. And during that time, she's been responsible for hand-raising 6 baby gorillas, including Missouri, the first gorilla ever to be born by artificial insemination in Australia.
You must have had an amazing bond with him.
Yes, that was an amazing animal, an amazing gorilla. And he was well loved by the Australian people. So he became a big icon for Australia, Melbourne Zoo. And we were actually able to use Missouri to bring the plight of the gorillas in the wild across to the public.
Gorillas face a number of threats in the wild, but none greater than habitat loss. Habitat that's mined for coltan, a substance found in mobile phones. These gorillas serve as ambassadors for their wild cousins, helping to raise awareness about the fight they face.
Do you have a favourite moment from over the past 40 years? A favourite moment when it comes to hand-raising gorillas?
My favourite moments is when we can put the hand-raised babies back into their group situation and they well adjusted and well accepted. You never want a hand-raised gorilla baby. That's really the last resort, and it's nothing nicer to see the babies with their mothers.
But in Yakini's case, there was no choice. Uli ultimately saved his life, and the bond they share will last forever.
Hey, happy birthday. I bought you a special treat for Melbourne Zoo. Wow. You good boy? Hey.
Uli, what an amazing animal and what an amazing person you are. Thank you from Yakini and from all the little baby gorillas that you've helped to raise. And I guess we should both wish the birthday boy a very happy birthday.
Yep, happy birthday, mate.
Happy 18th, Yakini.
That was a great story.
Isn't that beautiful? Reminds me of another tale about a creature who was bottle fed until it started acting like a wild gorilla. My friend Darren.
And a big thank you to the wonderful Nat Hunter for that incredible story. And you know, there are some risks when covering a story like this. Check out what happened to poor Nat.
But despite their size and strength, there's a threat that's pushing these amazing animals to the brink of extinction. I'm not talking about a predator. Believe it or not, the major threat to gorillas comes from us humans and use of our electronic devices like our mobile phones.
Ooh! Oh! Because they are ginormous, scary creatures.
Holy Batmobile.
They really don't like mobile phones, do they?
No! And of course, if you'd like to get involved and protect gorillas on the brink of extinction, you can do so by donating your mobile phone. You can head to zoo.org.au to find out more.